Every day we read Kadesh Likol Bechor Peter Mivnei Israel. We have three types of Bechorot. We have the Bechor Adam, the human Bechor, which every woman when she gives the first firstborn, they make a pidyon. The second one is a Bechor of Behema, that in the time of Bet HaMikdash, all the firstborn of the kosher animal used to sacrifice in the Mizbeach. And the third one is a little bit different, is the firstborn of the donkey. We'll talk shortly why the Torah single out the donkey. As the Pasuk say, kol peter kol peter rechem hamor tivde v'imlo v'arafto. Chatam Sofer extend this. He explained there is three categories of the Bechorot. He applies all this to Yetziat Mitzrayim. He said the Bechor Adam corresponds to the physical redemption of Am Israel from Mitzrayim. When we went out from Egypt, that's why we bring the Bechorot of the Adam, of the human Bechorot. The second one, the Bechor Behema, correspondent to the spiritual exit from Eretz Mitzrayim. It is something ruhani. We gain something by getting from Mitzrayim. So we bring the korban of Behema, which is something spiritual. Korban is something spiritual. And the third one is the Peter Hamor, the firstborn of the donkey that we kill, correspondent to the Bechorot of the Mitzrayim that were killed. But there is something here. The Torah gives you an option. First of all, you can redeem the Peter Rechem. If you don't redeem him, only you kill him. Why is that? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu doesn't forget anything. When Bnei Israel went out from Mitzrayim, they used all the donkeys to help them carry all the gold and to load all the gold and silver that they had. And that's why they have this option. So either you get redeemed, if not, only you kill them. And the first choice is to redeem them. Few halachot about Bechorot. There's many, many halachot. We'll touch maybe two or three. First of all, we're talking about Bechor Adam. The only one that obligated to do it is Israeli woman that marries to Israeli man. If it's a Kohen or Levi, it's Patur. Why they are Patur? Because when they were in the desert, the Leviim, if you read in the Parasha, they were able to redeem the Bechorot of Am Israel. So if they were able to... What about Behema, Pidyon Bechor Behema in our days? We don't have Bet HaMikdash, so the halacha really was supposed to be, we have to wait in every Bechor, every firstborn of the Behemot, until you get a blemish, and then you can slaughter and eat it. But we don't do that. In our days, because there is a lot of problems with it. If you keep the Bechor and you let him wait until there is blemish into it, you may come to work with him, to use his wool, and then you aware of Mitzvato Taaseh. You cannot work with the Bechor. So that's why the rabbis decided now in our days, we sell a small part, a small share of the Bechor to the Goy. All the Bechorot we're doing like that, and like that there is no Mitzvah of Pidyon Bechor, and you can do whatever you want with it. Finally, there's always something that attracts me in the Masechet that I like to share it with you. There was in one of the pages, there were in the give and the take of the Gemara, they were brought a pasuk that says et hagamal, and some of the rabbis learn from the word et that it comes to include also, it's not that we are not allowed to eat only the camel, also is milk, it's not allowed. So he is the guy that make the derashah, they use the word et. We look, there was one Tana in the Gemara that always used to make the derashot of the etim. His name was Rabbi Shimon HaAmsoni. He was Doresh every et in the Torah. That was his project. Let's say the Pasuk say, Kabed et avicha ve'et imecha. What is the et? Et is coming to include also your brother, your bigger brother there, and the et of the imecha, your bigger sister. Every pasuk that has et, he had a derashah to it. When he arrived to the pasuk, et Hashem Elohecha tira, he stopped. Who I'm going to include here? Et Hashem Elohecha tira. He stopped. He said, you know what? I'm retiring. So his student told him, Rabbi, what about all your derashot? He said, כשם שקיבלתי שכר על הדרשה, על הדרשה, אני מקבל על הקבל שכר על על הפרישה. As I was getting reward when I was making the explanation, I will get a reward also for withdrawing from explanation. I don't, that's it, that's the red line here. So come Rabbi Akiva, he's like from the outside. He comes and he tell him, no, you don't have to give up your life project. There is an explanation here. את השם אלוהיך תירא, לרבות תלמידי חכמים. You can, תלמידי חכמים are representative of Hashem. So you can really, when you say Hashem אלוהיך תירא, you have also to respect the תלמידי חכמים. Nothing wrong with that. And you don't have to leave your life project. So the question is asked, was this דרשה, את השם אלוהיך תירא, לרבות תלמידי חכמים? It's a very hard thing to find out. Couldn't רבי שמעון המסוני by himself find it out? It's not something very hard. He had to wait for Rabbi Akiva to come and tell him. It shows you the greatness of the sages of Am Israel. He could not have this gaava, this pride, to say את השם אלוהיך תירא לרבות תלמידי חכמים. I cannot say it. He was ready to give his life project just not to have this gaava of saying it. Therefore, when Rabbi Akiva saw such a tremendous character, it's a supernatural thing. It's like something divine that someone is ready to give his lifetime project just not to make this derasha. He is ra'uy. He is worthy to say et Hashem Elohecha tira. Rabbi Akiva is from the side, and he said it. Baruch Adonai l'olam amen v'amen. We're starting now Masechet Arachim. Chacham v'chavod Masechet Arachim.
כל מעריכים בין העירכים מלך, זה כאן וחי אל על השי וחד ועקו עליי יש בתורה של פרשת בחוקותיי שדה זה נפעל את המקדש הכל מעריכים בין העירכים כמעט נודרים בין תארים יעקוד נדור ואם סמברי נדב ביתו כהנים, נביאים וישראלים, נשים ועבדים טומטום ואנדרגונות נודרים בין תארים מעריכים אבל לא נערבים שאין נערב אלא זכר וזכר בדי ונקבה בדי מעל תורה אם נקבה אם זכר רק אין חרש רק אין טומטום אנדרוגינוס אינם נדרים חרש שוטה בפתה נדרים ונערבים אבל לא נודרים ולא מעריכים אינם הכסים כולם נודרים לנו חרש שוטה בפתה מעדור דעת מפני שאין בהם דעת
Thank you, Rabbi Baruch. Then we do the Siddur. We have to read the Adran. Here, Adran Alach, Masechet Bechorot.